Asante sana. Tafadhali tuketi. Asanteni. Baba wetu Askofu George Mechumo, Askofu viongozi wetu wa dini, viongozi wenzangu mlio hapa, ndugu wa Kristo wa hapa Bungoma, hamjambo. Bungoma mrembe. Mwami Yesu itsomiwe. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Mimi kwanza nataka nimshukuru Mungu ametupatia nafasi. Tumefika hapa kanisani siku ya leo. Najua viongozi wamesema ya kwamba uamuzi wa kuja hapa kanisani ilikuwa ni wa ghafla. Na lakini mimi nilipata nafasi kidogo na nikakumbuka rafiki yangu George Mechumo. Na nikasema sijapata nafasi ya kuja hapa kanisani kwa muda. Na nikasema nitachukua hii nafasi nifike hapa kanisani niweze kuabudu pamoja na nyinyi. Na mimi naelewa mambo ya kanisa kwa sababu nimelelewa kanisani. Hawa wanasiasa wenzangu saa zingine wanapata matatizo. Tukitaka kuja kanisani wanataka kumobilize. Lakini mimi najua quorum ya kanisa. Biblia inasema mahali wawili ama watatu Mungu yuko pale. So kwa sababu quorum ya kanisa ni tatu, sasa hakuna haja kumobilize. So tunakuja kanisani na hata hakuna haja ya notice mrefu. Tunakuja kanisani tunaomba. Mimi nimefurahi sana askofu wetu kutukaribisha hapa kanisani. Asante sana kwa kutunenea neno la Mungu. Na mimi nikiwa hapa Bungoma niko nyumbani kabisa. Hii ni county ya nyumbani. Kwa sababu tuko na uhusiano, tuko na urafiki wa miaka nyingi na tuko na mambo mengi tunafanya pamoja na nyinyi ya maendeleo ya taifa letu na vile vile ya maendeleo ya hapa Bungoma. Niliona kwa sababu leo baadaye nitasafiri kwenda nje ya nchi. Nikaona ya kwamba kuna kazi niliwacha hapa ikifanyika ya stadium na niliona nipitie hapo ndio nijue kama nitaenda kutafuta pesa ingine ya kukamilisha hiyo stadium na mambo mengine ambayo yanahusiana na maendeleo ya sehemu hii. Nataka niwashukuru ninyi nyote watu wa Bungoma, hasa viongozi wetu wa dini, kwa kutuombea na kuombea taifa letu la Kenya. We are a God-fearing nation, and we are unapologetically so. We believe in God. We trust in God's guidance. And nothing is going to harm this nation because we know we trust in a living God. So, I want to say thank you very much for our friends who have come from different parts of the world. Our friends from Uganda, the bishop from Uganda, and all the other good friends from different parts of the world who have come to Bungoma. I want to welcome you on behalf of the people of Bungoma and the people of Kenya to work with us as we build God's kingdom, as we celebrate God's providence, and as we march on towards the destiny that God has provided for us. As Richard has said, Reverend Richard has said, I am an evangelist. And many people sometimes wonder why I stand in raised places, sometimes on top of the car, Because when your orientation is an evangelist, you always behave like an evangelist, even when you are doing other things. And by the way, I have given a commitment that when I finish my tour of duty as president, I will go back to be an evangelist. Because that is my original calling. And so, Bishop, continue to pray for our nation, continue to pray for our country. Na nimekuja hapa kanisani leo na shukurani nyingi. Niko na shukurani nyingi sana. Kwa sababu ya yale Mungu ametutendea mengi. Penye mimi nimeketi, naona baraka ya Mungu katika taifa letu la Kenya. Mambo matatu muhimu yamefanyika katika taifa letu la Kenya. Ya kwanza, Mungu ametupatia majira mazuri. God has given us abundance of good weather in Kenya for the last 2 years. I overflew from, you know, my county in Eldoret all the way to Bungoma and many parts of Kenya. I overflew different parts of Kenya in the last 1 week. And we have plenty of food around Kenya. The Minister for Agriculture, I saw him announce that we will hit 70 million bags of maize, for example, this year, the highest ever. And it is God's providence. God has given us good rains, the hard work of our farmers, the partnership with government and all the other people who are assisting our farmers. God has blessed our country with food and food security. And I want to say we thank God for his providence. Number two, as I promised the people of Kenya, we have changed the conversation in our country. Today, when I listen to Makali here, when I listen to Atandi 2 days ago, when I listen to many members of parliament across Kenya, the conversation we are having is about our development, the schools that we are building. As Makali has said, that he wants more classrooms in Bungoma DEB, the electricity connection we are doing around Kenya, the roads we are building. So that conversation as to this road was promised, has not been built, that road is ongoing, but slowly that road is going on well. That conversation about issues, development in our country is a very, very positive conversation. It is the conversation that I always wanted Kenya to have. Not a conversation about our ethnicities or our differences in religion or other sectarian interests. I am very proud that we are having, as a country, the right conversation. Conversation about the development of our country. Conversation about the issues that inform the progress, transformation, and prosperity of our nation. And in that way, collective responsibility of our country. I ask Bishop Mechimo and all the other bishops and all the other men and women of goodwill, men of God around Kenya, to continue to pray for us so that our focus remains on how we transform our country. And thirdly, God has blessed us with the words of Matthew 5:9. Blessed are the peacemakers. Heri wapatanishi. I have just come from a trip in Nyanza. And it is amazing what God can do. You know, it is almost a miracle that the people who are on extreme sides a few months ago, today, we are speaking as though we are very long time brothers and sisters and friends. And that is the beauty of our country. That is the beauty of our country. That when circumstances demand, we close ranks as a people, we forge alliances as a people, we build bridges as Kenyans, and we work together for the greater good of our nation. And I want to encourage and promise us as Kenyans that those who want to divide us will fail, and they will fail miserably. Those who want to preach to us sectarian, ethnic, parochial, regional politics will not succeed in this country, because this country is a country that trusts in God, and all of us are children of the same God. And so every leader, those of us who have the privilege to be leaders in Kenya, at whatever level, we must understand, we must appreciate that we are leaders for the people of Kenya. And it doesn't matter, just like Lusaka here, he was not voted for everybody in Bungoma. Yeah, almost 40% of the people did not vote for him, but he's the governor for Bungoma, all the people of Bungoma, and he must work for all the people of Bungoma. And I also promise that I will work for all the people of Kenya without discrimination, without exclusion, because that is what is demanded of government by the Constitution, and I am perfectly aware that it is also the will of God to work with everybody, to work for the people of Kenya in their entirety, in their unity. And I want to promise Kenyans that I will go out of my way. I will do whatever it takes to make sure that this country is united and that no part of Kenya is left behind as we march into the future as a people. It is our collective responsibility as leaders to walk in that manner. I know some people, you know, ask questions. What happens to us? Those of us in Bungoma who voted overwhelmingly for this administration. We may ask, what happens to us? We can see Atandi and all the other people are, you know, surging into this place. What happens to us? I want to tell you that this country, God designed it in a way that all of us can belong. And whatever is in Kenya, if we work together, we can bake a bigger cake that all of us can be satisfied. So nobody should worry about the unity of Kenya. In fact, if there is any worry, it is not the unity of Kenya. It is the disunity, if at all. That should worry anybody. So, Bishop, nimefurahi sana kufika hapa. Mimi naona kama nimelipa deni ya urafiki ya huyu askofu ambaye ameniombea sana na amenitafutia marafiki wengi. Na najua mlikuwa mmepanga kuwa na mavuno huyu makali ameninongonezea ya kwamba mlikuwa mmepanga kunialika kwa hiyo mavuno ya mwezi wa 11. Nikipata nafasi nitakuja. Nisipopata nafasi niko na marafiki wengi nitawatuma. Mnajua simnajua mimi ni mkulima. Mimi ni mkulima sugu kabisa. Ya mahindi, Mimi ni mti ya kuku. Nauza mayai mingi sana. Mkiniona hivi. So kwa ile mahindi nimepanga na Mungu na nimepanda na Mungu amenibarikia. Niko na mahindi kiasi hapo nyumbani. So kwa hiyo mavuno yenu nitawatumia mifugo 1,000 ya mahindi. Nasikia. Kwa sababu sinasemekana 10%. 10%. Na niko na mahindi kuzidi hiyo 10% hata ni more than 1,000. So nitawapatia kiasi. Niko na makanisa ingine nyumbani huko nitawapatia pia kidogo kidogo. Sina namna hiyo. Alafu naambiwa ya kwamba mnataka kupanua jengo lenu la kanisa. Mimi nawaeleza ya kwamba tutasaidiana pamoja na nyinyi. As you plan to expand this sanctuary, because the town is growing, and by the way, we are going to be building another big city just outside here. We already are working on the plans where we had an airstrip here. We are going to put there maybe another 10,000 housing units. So we need to expand this church because there will be more people coming to this church. And so the other matters, I'm very happy that I will be speaking to other people in a different forum. But again, to the church here, I want to say thank you very much for welcoming us to Bungoma again. Thank you, Bishop, for speaking to us the word of God. And thank you, all the friends, for your goodwill and continue to pray for our nation. Thank you very much, and God bless you. I forgot something. Just give me a minute. This Makali fellow, our member of parliament, who is also my friend, has asked me about the school. And I'm told the school is just across the road. So, Makali, I will help you build those classrooms. And before I leave this town, nitakuwa nimekusota.